Chapter 3, Class 7th, Data Handling. In the previous sessions, we have already learnt about the three steps of data handling. First one, collection of data. Second one, organization of data. And the third one is presentation of data. So what we are going to do in this session? To know about it, just answer the following question. The question is, if you toss a coin, then can you predict what will you get? I think no one can predict what will we get after tossing a coin. So your answer is definitely no. Now let's try to find out a pattern by tossing the same coin 10 times. So now I am trying to find out a pattern for predicting what will I get by tossing this coin for 10 times. So after tossing the coin for 10 times, I get the following result. So here, this table shows the outcomes which I get after tossing the coin. After first toss, I get a head. After second toss, I get tail. After third toss, I get head, and so on. So now just look at the following table and tell me, is there any predictable pattern? If you just look at this table, then definitely you cannot find out any pattern here. What does this data tell? Can you find any predictable pattern for head and tail? So our answer is no, we cannot find any predictable pattern for head and tail. This data doesn't tell anything about what we will going to get after each toss of this coin. So since there is no fixed pattern of occurrence of head and tail, so whenever you throw a coin, either you will get a head or you will get a tail. It is just a matter of chance that in one throw you will get whatever you predict. For example, let us suppose that before tossing the coin for 10 times, I predict that after 5th toss, I am going to get a tail. I am again repeating, my prediction is that after 5th toss of the same coin, I am going to get a tail. And when I do this activity, then I got the same result. So this does not mean that the coin will fall according to my wish. This is just a matter of chance. So in this session, we are going to learn about chance and how to measure the possibility of a chance. So before learning, we have to see some of the situations in our life. There are situations in our life that are certain to happen, some that are impossible, and some that may or may not happen. So, we are dividing the situations in our life under three categories. The first category consists of all those situations that are certain to happen. The second category consists of all those situations that are impossible. And the third category consists of all those situations that may or may not happen. So we are dividing the situations in our life in three categories. So now let's try to understand these situations by some examples. So the first category consists of all those situations that are certain to happen. So here are some of the examples of situations which are certain to happen. The first example is, the sun rises from the east. If you take a circle of larger area, then its radius will also be larger. And the third one is you are older today than yesterday. So these are the situations that are certain to happen. Why? Because sun never rises from any other direction. The sun always rises from east. In the second example, if you are taking a circle of larger area, then automatically its radius will also be larger. And you are always older today than the yesterday. Yesterday means the previous day. So these are the situations that are certain to happen. Now let's see some of the examples of situations that are impossible. So the first situation is the sun rises from the west. The sun always rises from the east. So it is impossible that the sun rises from the west. So this is a situation which is impossible. Now the second situation is a die when tossed up shall land up with 8 on top. Since you know that a die has number ranging from 1 to 6 only. So if we toss a die, then obviously you will never get 8 on top. So this is again an impossible situation. The third situation is an ant growing to 3 meter height. This is again a situation which is impossible. Why? Because the height of an ant cannot be equals to 3 meter. Now let's move on to the situations which may or may not happen. The first situation is India winning the next test series. Since we cannot predict who will win the test series, so this is a situation which may or may not happen. The second situation is a die when tossed up shall land up with 5 on top. As we have already discussed that when you toss a die, then you will get either 1 or 2 or 3 or 4 or 5 or 6. Since a die has number ranging from 1 to 6, so you can get any one of them. So this is again a situation which may happen or which may not happen. You will get 5 on top or you will not get 5 on top. Now the third situation is the next traffic light seen will be green. Sometimes the next traffic light seen will be green, but sometimes the next traffic light will be red also. So this is a situation which may happen or which may not happen. So in this way you can categorize the situations under three categories. The first category, situations that are certain to happen. The second situations that are impossible, and the third situations that may or may not happen. Now the question arises, why we are discussing about situations in life? We are discussing because the situations that may or may not happen, these type of situations have a chance of happening. We can say they can happen or they cannot happen. So since these situations have a chance of happening, so we need a measurement for measuring this chance of occurrence of a given situation. That measurement is known as probability. So let's see what is probability and how do you calculate it. So probability of an event is a measure of how likely the event is to occur. It does not tell us exactly what will happen. It is just a guide. So what does probability measure? It measures the likelihood of occurrence of an event. A event will happen or not. So probability will measure the likelihood of happening of an event. So the formula of probability is number of ways it can happen. It means the event. The number of ways the event can happen divided by the total number of outcomes. So now let's try to understand the concept of probability by an example. The first example is tossing a coin once. So whenever you toss a coin, you either get a head or a tail. So after tossing a coin, we can get either head or tail. So there are two possible outcomes. So the total number of outcomes equals to 2. And these two outcomes are head and tail. So if you toss a coin, you will either get a head or a tail. Now, the probability of getting a head. Out of these two outcomes, head will occur how many times? Only one time. So the number of ways head can occur is 1, or you can say the number of ways of getting a head equals to 1, and the total number of outcomes equals to 2. So the probability equals to 1/2. Similarly, the number of ways of getting a tail. How many ways we are getting a tail? We are getting a tail only once. So the probability of getting tail equals to 1/2. 1 is the number of ways of getting tail and 2 is the total number of outcome. Now let's move on to another example. Tossing a die once. So now I am tossing a dice. Since a dice has 6 numbers, these 6 numbers are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So whenever you toss a dice, you can get 1 or 2 or 3 or 4 or 5 or 6. So there are 4 possible outcomes which you can get after tossing a dice. So the total number of outcomes equals to 6. Now the probability of getting 1 is equals to number of ways of getting 1. So here how many ways I can get 1? So there is only one way of getting a 1. So probability of getting 1 equals to 1/6, where 6 is the total number of outcomes. Similarly, the probability of getting 2 equals to 1/6, where 1 is the number of ways 2 can occur. So here 2 can occur only one time. So the number of ways of occurrence of 2 is 1, and the total number of outcomes is 6. So the probability of getting 2 equals to 1/6. In this way, you can calculate the probability of getting the other outcomes as well. Now let's see another example. A container has 15 red balls. So there is a container in which 15 red balls are there and 9 white balls. So the container has 15 red balls and 9 white balls. And if a ball is drawn out without seeing, so you are not seeing the ball and you are drawing a ball from the container. So after drawing a ball, either you will choose a ball from these 15 red balls, or you can also draw a ball from these 9 white balls. So the total number of outcomes of getting a ball equal to 15 plus 9, because you can select any ball out of these red and white balls. So the total number of outcomes equals to 15 plus 9, that is 24. Now, what is the probability of getting a red ball? Since the container has only 15 red balls, so you can select any one of them. So there are 15 chances of selecting a red ball. So the probability of getting a red ball equals to 15 upon 24. 15 is the number of ways you can select a red ball, and 24 is the total number of outcomes. Total number of outcomes means total number of balls in the container. Now, probability of getting a white ball. Since the container has only 9 white balls, so you can select a white ball from these 9 balls. So you only have 9 ways of selecting the white balls. So the probability of getting white ball equals to 9 by 24. So in this way, you can calculate the probability of occurrence of any event.